cette émission. Comment gérer l'intermittence à l'heure de la décarbonation? Il y a une illustration très concrète de notre fil rouge tout au long de cette journée. Comment l'open innovation nous permet de résister à la crise et de répondre aux enjeux de demain. Bien sûr, pour en parler, on va réaliser autour de cette
Je voulais quand même revenir avec vous sur le travail que vous fournissez Stanislas, aux côtés des startups parce que c'est important.
We need energy that will have to be available, cheap, and decarbonated, and this is a challenge that we all have to take up, you know, all of us companies, startups, researchers, scientists, academics, and so on. So how can we do that with less emissions? So we've made a very strong announcement in addition to this change of name and commitments for carbon neutrality and scope 3, that is to say the use of the product, the use we're making of our products. And we would like to get 100 gigawatts of renewable energy by 2030. So this is a collective challenge, and one of the difficulties with renewable energy is that it depends on climate. So this is intermittent. So the question is how to manage it properly in order to continue benefiting from a reliable, available, affordable, decarbonated energy. Well, this is essential in the ecosystem of energies. Yeah, you know, for the electric system, you must have a stable situation between what is produced and what is being used, and replacing a thermal power plant that could be piloted and that were highly easy to forecast, are being replaced with a plant using a renewable energy, which are more difficult to forecast. So that's why we have to think about new ways of working, one of them being to use energy storage station and to be able to move energy conversion systems. You know, and this in order to continue living. And it's like with a human body, we will need the systems to monitor that. You know, for the human body, you have your five senses and all the information are being sent to the brain that is managing everything. Well, that's the same thing here for us. We will need sensors, information on our system, you know, like the eyes for our human body. We will need arms to act on the system. This is what ESOX is proposing. And we will need a brain to combine information from the eye and transmit them to the arms, and this is the EMS system in English. So perfect orchestration with all of you four being around this table, you know, to see how we can cope with this new system. But if we continue with human body analogy, the production of renewable energy, what is it? A production of renewable energy, this is a bit like environmental environment for the human body. You know, when you go out, if it's cold or warm, then you will do specific actions. Well, to replace a thermal generation that have specific flows that you know in terms of waste, well, climate, we will have to adapt to climate changes so that renewable take over from thermal production without endangering the system. So again, this is a good instrument. It's a bit like pain for the human body because it tells us when we understand that we are getting into danger, and it's a bit like the same thing with that ecosystem. Now we will go towards Nicolas, who is in the Réunion Island. So lucky, he's so lucky to be there. You are the CEO of ReUniWatt and the laureate of French Tech 120, which has published its awards a few weeks ago. So you are focusing on photovoltaic panels. This is a real challenge to manage intermittency, because even with sun energy and photovoltaic panel, you know, if this is cloudy or if it is like what we had yesterday, where, you know, you had sun and heavy showers, well, you know, to deploy sun energy, it has to be stored beforehand, and this is where you intervene.
Dans la question, j'ai respecté la question sociale que vous mettez debout pour la bonne barrière. Et notre métier, effectivement, nous, c'est prévoir.
Well, we have to plan the photovoltaic generation. So we have to plan what will be sent to the grid in the future, in the coming minutes or in the coming hours, to have a good balance between offer and demand. So what you're proposing is a forecast of how you can roll out the energy that has been previously stored. Is that it? Or am I saying something wrong? We will try to see how we can better manage the balance between what is rolled out, what is being stored. You know, we can, if we see cloud coming up, we will be able to forecast a generation, and our system will monitor storage and direct injection. So we're working hand in hand on the value chain, and this on both or at both ends of the system. What is your link with Paris-Saclay? Why are we in touch with you, who are in La Réunion? Though we're talking about startups and companies here in Paris-Saclay. Well, we have been working with Total for a very long time. We've worked on other projects such as Easy Grid in Issy-les-Moulineaux. But the link between ReUniWatt and Saclay is a long-term one. I have studied in Saclay, and then with ReUniWatt, we have participated to a smart grid project that was coming up from Saclay, and we have deployed our equipment on the roof of an excellence center in Saclay for climate measurement. So it shows that there's a consistency between how you may have studied in Saclay and one of these universities and developing innovative solutions. But if we were to give a new argument to say why we're doing that, why is ReUniWatt so innovative? More than 300,000 hours of R&D, which is a lot. We are only 5 years old. We have 5 patents. We are working on the forecasting chain. We have patents for observing the cloud. clouds from the Skype satellite, and also patents on imaging systems where you're looking at the sky from the ground with infrared images so that you can see the sky at night and day, and you can assess the height of the cloud and the thickness of the shadow. Well, I understand now why you're part of this system of intermittency management. So what is expected from a company such as Reniwatt at Total? Well, in 2011, when we took over SunPower, we were faced with a problem of sun penetration. You know, if we wanted to do that, we had to plan intermittency, and we found Reniwatt, who was offering us what we wanted, and we were very happy in our cooperation because we were really working hand in hand. And when you have startups proposing what you need, then you can deploy your team on other topics and have them focusing on other topics. And I can see that Nicolas is delighted for the way you are working together. Now, if you allow, I will turn to the brain. That is to say, Cyril Collin for Elum. So if we go back to how everything is orchestrated in terms of intelligent or smart system, how would you react? As Nicolas and Stanislas said before me, there is a whole set of equipment that are set up on site, you know, mainly sensors, and they will provide us information.
And the idea of piloting is to make the right decision and send the decision to each equipment to pilot them. So you have equipment that will collect information.
And as you can see on the diagram, we will monitor the injection of sun energy in batteries or towards the grid, or monitor the recharging of a priority electric vehicle, you know, versus prices or uses and so on.
Entre la réalité du système et les contraintes qu'on a sur la partie
to the reality of the system and take into consideration your constraints and make things available for buildings. Does it mean that you can customize the forecasting of intermittency? We have a constraint which is the generation of energy and what we are able to store and use, and then you have to play with the different variable data available, how much energy stored in your battery, in your electric car, and so on. And according to those constraints, you're going to optimize and make the best choice to maximize the injection of sun energy and not waste it. Because if you're not managing it properly, we're going to lose sun energy because we won't be able to store it or inject it into the grid. So what you are offering is a site and navigation, a system to deploy the store energy. But what would you need to go even further? To let the market go where it wants to go, we had historical support from the state for this system. And now this is profitable. More than half of installed capacity in the world is coming from sun energy. So this is a solution that is profitable. So what you have to do is let things develop themselves and promote new technologies such as storage of hydrogen. This is long-term storage, and you can couple it with short-term storage, that is to say lithium batteries, and further push for the setting up of electrical vehicle recharging terminals. Well, here we're talking about hybrid. Do we have a decarbonated hybrid by design? It depends on what you mean with hybrid. You know, we're talking about coupling historical energy of the grid with local production of sun energy. So here we have different sources of energy and different places where it can be sent to batteries to store it and use it later, or you can inject it into the grid for being used at some point. I'll come back to you to understand why Elm could only be set up in Saclay, but Stanislas, I believe that you've fallen in love with a serious project. Immediately, it's important to have this last chakra to control all of the planning of the production. Well, I joined Total in 2017, and I met Cyril in 2017, so everything went quite fast. So we have renewable energy, we have this intermittency, so I need to know what is going to happen, and once I know that, I need to act, and that's why I needed to have those controllers, those EMS system, and we've come up with a hybrid photovoltaic system, or testing center close to Lyon. And the tests carried out there have been positive, and we've continued working together. So we've talked about energy generation upstream, but what is happening downstream in the premises and in order to better use those smart systems? Well, again, to manage intermittency, you need to know what is going to happen. You need to send orders, storage that Cyril talked about. But you have also charges that can be monitored in order to adapt to production of renewable energy. You have recharging of electrical vehicles. You have heating, hot water, industrial processes. And we have a project to equip premises in Saclay to create a micro energy building. And this is when we've worked with ASX. So Maxence from ASOX, how do you work at your company? We want to better manage the heating of building. It represents 50% of energy consumption in France, and usually it's not well managed. You know, usually specific buildings are heated on a permanent basis because we don't know how to do it differently. We have hundreds of different rooms. We have different types of occupations, so you have to understand intermittency. So we want to equip each hot water radiator with a set of sensors, environmental sensors and presence sensors, and understanding the use of the room, managing the presence of absence of people in the room. So we're going to manage intermittency of the room, and in order to save energy and provide energy efficiency to the building. Well, a few years ago, we were talking about smart building. Everything had to become smart. And this is a good illustration of how we can make heaters smart as well, and how they in enabling them to decide about how to manage energy. And, you know, we are in a context of health crisis. Sometimes you're working on-site, sometimes remote. And you have to adapt your consumption even more than before. Yeah, we know the consumption rate of buildings, and it is being readapted to new uses or new ways of working, and that's the whole strength of our system. Smart buildings, you know, instead of waiting for the users to command or order the system to say what to do with the heating system, well, the the heating device will decide alone what to do. So we do not have to manage this heating system ourselves. So you're enabling your customers to save about 40% in terms of energy consumption. Of course, it varies a lot according to the type of building, but we have this 40% energy saving. And this is completely independent from management. So it's going to simplify building management systems. We are going to simplify systems, and automation will take over from human decision. So our Total Energy experts are committed to this energy transition. We want to have energies, different types of energies being valued. How did this meeting with Stanislav happen? We met at the CES in Las Vegas. Well, nice place to go. And that's a meeting place for innovation. And we have all interest in working with energy provider. We have to produce a greener energy and to avoid wasting energy within a building. And this is our mission, to avoid wasting energy. Well, Stanislav, well, you've already said a few words about that, but why was MaxSense project essential to test this intermittency system? What are the outlook for those EMS? Well, this is going to grow up, you know, today variations can be adapted by rotating machines such as thermal power plant, but the more renewable energy we will have, the more difficult it will be for rotating machines to absorb changes, and we will have to come up with complementary solutions, and this is already the case in overseas territory, and this is something that Nicolas knows a lot. You know, when you're reinjecting renewable energy, you need storage solution, you know, to cope with a peak of consumptions in the evening when the sun is going down. So management of intermittency is going to become more and more important, and we will need more smart intelligence to manage all that. And that's why there's a huge difference between being in France or in the south of Florida. Well, before concluding, I wanted to know whether those projects, you know, with companies, with customers, companies that are recruiting, that are coming up with turnover and so on, why was exactly the right place to set up your company and to further develop it? This is the right place because you can go further, you know. Very often, you tend to stick to your building and that's it. But here you can link companies, you can share things, you can and work on a bigger systems with you know the whole smart ecosystem. We are complementary. This is a living giant lab. Is it same thing with you, Cyril? Same thing. Yeah. We are. This company was created because I met with my partner at the Polytechnic Higher Education School, and it was done, you know, thanks to our training in school. And the part of the research and development we're doing is being done in Saclay because we're working in partnership with labs from the Saclay area, the dynamic meteorological lab, and we have set up a site on one of the universities with sun production systems and storage systems. So, indeed.
Dernier mot avec vous, Stanislas. Encore une fois,
Stanislav.
Comment est-ce qu'on pourrait synthétiser cet écosystème?
How could we summarize this ecosystem of renewable energies that is being created? is it the future of climate transition? You know, when we are talking about energy transition, climate transition, does it necessarily mean working with companies such as those developed by Cyril, Nicolas, or Maxence? Well, this is a topic that is very complex, and that's why everybody is involved, large companies, academics, startups, and even citizens. Nobody will manage to do it alone, even a large company such as Total. So we have to learn how to operate together, everyone, you know, bring their own assets. And to do that, it's interesting to have places such as Paris-Saclay, where you have large companies, startups, academics in the same place with a lot of things put in common for this cooperation. And this even is the very example of that. You know, Total is quite present here in Saclay. We are working in partnership with other academic companies. We have this project of connected buildings. We are working with Energy for Climate Lab, which is a pluridisciplinary lab, and we have many other things ongoing around artificial intelligence, because another key element in managing those systems is to be able to plan what is going to happen. So we need eyes and so on, but we have to be able to interpret what is being seen. And this is where artificial intelligence jumps in. And, you know, for many years we've tried to plan or forecast climate. Well, it's going to be the same thing with energy, indeed, to evaluate and in order to get reliable information in many different areas and industries. Thank you to all of you, Stanislas, Cyril, Maxence, and Nicolas, listening to us from La Réunion.
Gentlemen, I suppose we'll meet again at the next project, you know, like Paris-Saclay's Spring for 2021. Now the next panel, and this time we'll go back to Sandra, because quantum technology is at the forefront of all the startups. Everyone's running after this technology, which is more than a revolution. And Paris-Saclay, as you know, is in the front line when it comes to quantum technology. So let's talk with Sandra about it.